The last 20 years, we have noticed a severe reduction in fertility in the dairy cows. And we do think, at least in Ghent, we did a lot of work on that aspect. And we did see that there was a severe interaction between the reproduction and the production. So there's kind of competition for the energy between the production and reproduction. One of the most marked points to illustrate that is that most fertility problems are occurring in the dairy cows, not really in the heifers, which are not lactating. So we see this decline most of all in the dairy cows, so we do in the lactating dairy cows. So we do think that the lactation in se is not a good thing for reproduction, because this lactation is such a challenge for the metabolism of the cow that there is a decline in fertility.
In Europe-wise, I think there is a tremendous improvement in professionality. There have been a substantial loss of producers, and this loss has been mainly on the side of not very professional ones. So what we've left now is very professional producers that have data and make database decisions. That's very important, I think.
We do think that when we do not react on this thing, that fertility will further decline. And even for fun, we calculated in the UK that if this decline is going on this steady decrease, then we should say that in 2046, there will be no pregnant cow anymore in the UK.
Farmers, they tend to look at only on one side of the equation, which is meal price. And they also look at the other side, but not as much, which is costs. Medicines, bedding, feed cost. And they fail to look at the efficiency of conversion. In other words, the profitability of what they're spending and the return on that investment. And I think that's a subject that needs to be revisited and emphasized on the farmers. The major cost is simple. That's always the same. It's feed cost, and it will range between 40 and 70%, depending on the farms. The second one would be labor, and in Europe is an average of 15%. And then the third cost will be replacement heifers, which ranges between 10 and 15%, even sometimes 25%. So those are the three major areas I would focus on capturing some profitability on dairy herds.
So we do see that a lot of problems are management related problems. First of all, we know that this competition between production and reproduction is mainly based on the energy balance of the cow. And farmers should increase the energy balance of the cow shortly after calving by increasing the dry matter intake. So the golden trick there is that they should really increase cow comfort for the cows, so that the cows are really happy, are really eating a lot, so that the dry matter intake is okay, to reduce the bad effects of the negative energy balance. Another ever-returning point is the heat detection. So I do think that one of the major constraints nowadays for modern dairy farmers with those growing herds is the detection of the heat in the cows. In the past, when there were only a small number of cows on the herd, the farmer, he knew his cows by name. He had time to look to the cows. But now with this huge number of cows, of course, the farmer does not know the individual cow anymore. And on the other hand, he has no time, less and less time, to do very good heat detection. So heat detection is also a point which is an ever-returning problem in modern dairy cow fertility.
Ruminants and dairy cows especially, they only capture 25% of the protein they consume into milk. So the 75% of the protein that farmers have bought ends up in the gutter. It never reaches the milk. And there are ways nutritionally that you can maximize that to 38 or 35%. We cannot do better than that, but from 20 or 25% that most producers are to 35 or 36%, a big improvement in economy, on profit, and a big reduction in environmental impact. The first thing they can do is look at the ratio between their protein in the diet and the energy in the diet. And that ratio should be close to one. And the units of that is protein divided by 10, and then you divide that by the megacals of energy per kilo. And if it's close to one, I'll give you an example. A ration with 16% crude protein and 1.6 megacals of energy, that would be ratio of one. 16% divided by 10 is 1.6, divided by 1.6 is 1. That will give you an efficiency of about 30% conversion for protein, which is okay. It's better than the 25 that most people have.
When we historically look how veterinarians and practitioners were involved in fertility work, the major difference between the past and what I think should be the future is that in the past it was the client that was calling his vet to solve the problems. And in that respect, when we really look deeply in this point, then we see that when we wait until the farmer calls, we lose a lot of time. And I do think that practitioners, especially in those larger herds, this growing herd size, that there should be kind of software program that the practitioner himself can look from behind the shoulder of the farmer and really also detect the problems before even the farmer notices in the farm. So I do think that practitioners should really work more proactively, that they really get involved more deeply in a preventive way, looking to the data on the computer via the web, for example, to see how it is in the fertility. And as soon as he sees that some key fertility parameters are not good on the herd, that he takes action and not wait until the farmer really calls him.
BRD is a very common disease. It affects easily 25% of the cattle. And we just completed a study where we're looking at long-term effects of BRD. And what we found is that heifers that have a series of BRD cases, they last less in their herds. In other words, their productive life is compromised. And that has consequences on milk production, on profit, and also environmental impact, because you will need more replacements to replace these animals.
I think there is three main things that farmer can do to prevent BRD. The first thing is to better manage the calf, the young calf at birth. I think a good colostrum feeding program, for example, is something very, very important to manage BRD. A second thing is quality of the housing is very important for young calves and heifers too. And perhaps also have a good vaccination program to prevent BRD. Some vaccination programs should be developed to prevent BRD.
Producers are very focused on lactating cows and they tend to neglect a little bit replacements because they don't contribute to the profits. But they don't realize that what they do with replacements, it have long-term consequences in milk production in the future. Good example, a study that we've done involving close to 8,000 animals, we found out there is a relationship between body weight at calving and future milk production. And for every 70 kilos of body weight that you get at calving, additional body weight, you will be expecting on average 1,000 more liters of milk in the first lactation.
The size of the farm are increasing. This means that at least you increase the number of people working in the farm and you can increase the number of advisors working in the farm. And I think that the key is that the vet are on, let's say, board of this group of people that drive the farm and not stay outside this group. Every farm has different requests, and so you have to listen the language of the farmer. You have to discuss with the farmer, you have to speak the same language, and in the same way, you have to obtain to be on board when he's going to take decision.
I think a critical aspect that has happened in the United States is that the production systems have forced the veterinary profession to move away from looking for problem cows, emphasizing the exceptions, and moving towards the things that really make an impact on a dairy farm, which are herd health programs, vaccination programs, preventative measures, training employee, getting involved with nutrition, getting involved with facility design. So those are critical things that really make a difference on the economy of a dairy farm. And so when we talk about the education of the new vets as well as the continued education of already practicing vets, I think they need to become more comfortable with dealing with numbers, making recommendations for whole herd as opposed to focusing on individual medical cases as it's often been the case in the traditional veterinary medicine. So we need to be looking at more of a holistic approach to the role of the veterinarian as a pivotal a person in delivering information that makes a big impact, that will have a big impact on herd performance, herd health, and the economy of the dairy farm.